questions I want to ask Nancy, well, mostly Nancy, that I think will be educational for all of us, especially the new people. And I think educational for even some of the village people. Okay, Nancy, the airport. The airport is in our A fund.
Yes.
And you say, and the A fund is a tax rate that affects all taxpayers in the town, which means people that live in the village that are in the town, and people that live in the town outside the village. Correct? Okay. If there's a village expense, that expense is charged to town residents who live inside the village.
Correct? On the village
taxes. On the village taxes. Okay. So, where I'm headed is you've counseled this for as long as I've been on the board. They, well, and just to make sure everybody understands that a village resident that pays village taxes is the same person that pays town taxes that lives inside the village, correct? It's not two different people. Okay. We understand that. Sometimes I think people think it's totally different people. All right. You've counseled this for as long as I've been on the board, that the same person, the same taxpayer, cannot be charged for a service twice, correct? Okay. So, the village is asking for the complete cost of a patrolman going to the airport, correct? That's the $50,000, whether we agree with it or not. That's the dollar amount. Okay. If we move that money to the town, now that $50,000 is already in the village budget,
correct.
I assume.
We have to assume.
The police department is covered 100% by taxes, not by user fees or anything like that. So village residents who pay village taxes are already paying that money. Okay. So if that $50,000 is charged to the town, we cannot charge town residents inside the village their portion of that $50,000, correct? Because they would then be paying twice.
Well, I think what they're saying is, okay, we've incurred this expense, and they're considering that we're going to get that money from the TSA,
well,
not from taxpayers. But now we are going to have to.
Right. It's more than what we can get from the TSA, regardless of the TSA. That
really?
That bill is being said that they want to send a bill to the town.
Right.
The town funds the airport mm-hmm. with all taxpayers. So the portion of $50,000 that would apply then to town people inside the village would be a double taxation, and that
that's
cannot
like
be done, correct? Okay.
I'll
continue. Because again, when I said last week they're not thinking, you got to think through a lot of this stuff. Mm-hmm. Just developing a cost estimate doesn't mean you've thought through everything. Okay. That's where they gave me help. We thought about it. We put together the cost. Okay. Now, the best, most efficient splitting of costs that we have, I would propose, is anything that's jointly funded, because it will include West Messina people that are in the village, village residents, and town outside residents. So if the police protection at the airport was considered a joint project, just like recreation, every recreation employee is a village employee. Up till the hiring of Peter Devine, all code enforcement people were village employees. Okay? Police department people are village employees. So nothing's different. So if we consider that a joint funding, and if all joint funding was done by assessment, 60-40, the $50,000 charge, $30,000 of it would be charged to residents inside the village. $20,000 of it would be charged to residents outside the village. Correct? I think I'm getting this found. Okay. Now that would be assuming no funding from anywhere else. Now, we've got money that can come in from the TSA. $25,000 approximately. Would not that funding then cover all of the town outside people? It could all go to the village, and that would theoretically cover all of the costs along with the taxes that the village people are paying.
It's time to hit Old Man Winter with a 1-2 punch. It's time for a Fisher plow from Frenchie Chevrolet. The new Fisher XV2 plow features extreme flared wings, Fisher's trip edge design, super fast hydraulics, and more. The XV2 gives you both outstanding performance and maximum productivity every time you plow. Frenchie Chevrolet, 255 East Orvis Street, Messina, your Fisher plow headquarters in northern New York.
If you have a business and need more than just a computer salesman, StarTech is your answer. We have 4 technicians available with over 60 years combined experience for fast, efficient, quality service. We've been serving upstate New York since 1983. We support local and wide area networks, and we service most makes and models of computers and printers. We have a complete in-house service facility, and we offer on-site service to most areas.
StarTech, computer, cellular, and music equipment.
Do you think I'm right with everything I've said?
I do think you're right. Because we would have to do the billing for the whole thing.
Right.
And whatever, and I think that was always the idea, whatever we get, we give to them. So that
right.
There is no real additional cost to anybody.
Anybody, because they're already being paid. That's
right.
What we've been saying. They are already being paid by taxes.
Right, and whatever they get is bonus.
Right.
But
that's what I was trying to say. Anything that they get is a bonus to their budget.
Right.
And correct?
I think
I wasn't trying to demean anybody.
Right.
That is a truism, correct?
I think what they're saying in some of the emails I saw was, but we have incurred additional charges. We don't have proof of that. I mean, I haven't seen that.
That's where the $50,000 is.
Right. But they're saying, you know, yeah, we budget a certain amount of money for our police department, but this has caused us to have to spend more money.
I understand that, and that's
and
where the $50,000 came
yeah.
from, right? Because originally it was going to be whatever the TSA gave
right.
us, correct?
Right.
So if they were going to give us $25,000, that's what they would get. Mm-hmm. Now you're saying it's not $25,000, it's $50,000. The $50,000, the way I read it, is all any other additional charges that the real cost to do that job.
Right.
So, right now, all of that cost is within the village budget.
Yes.
if they transfer that money, again, cost to the town, we would have to spread it over. They would have to take it out of their budget. Or we're going to double tax people. And you can't double tax people. Correct? They haven't said they're going to do that. And I've been, that's why I've been, it's been stuck in my mind, and I'm not sure if it's been stuck in other people's mind, and the fact that they're already getting paid.
Yes.
They're already getting paid by the village taxpayers, who are the same people as the town taxpayers that live inside the village, other than West Messina. Mm-hmm. And then a joint funded thing is the best because it has the largest tax base. It includes West Messina, the village inside town, and town outside village. It's the largest tax base. So anything we fund jointly is the best. Well, I don't know.
You use that.
Theoretically, yeah. It has the largest assessed valuation underneath it. So recreation is a no-brainer because everybody that lives in West Messina, the village, the town, pay their fair share. And I've been on the board a long, long time, been confused by a lot of these things for a long, long time. But I think because you've been around all this time, you have coached us more than once. You can't double tax people. You cannot charge people for the same service twice. That's a fact, correct? Okay. I guess I'm done. Bottom line is, whatever we get from TSA is a plus, and it should cover the town outside residents.
Right.
And the town inside residents are already paying for this service. Mm-hmm. Okay.
John, just to clarify, you're saying they're paying for the service?
In their village taxes.
In the village taxes.
Because they're the same people.
Yep.
You live in the village, I live in the village, I pay a town tax, I pay a village tax. If I transfer, if I take $50,000 out of the village budget, and put $50,000 in the town inside the village budget, your tax total tax bill will change maybe by pennies. The budget, if your intention is to micromanage budgets, a lot of this we do is keep Nancy in the village treasurer busy. We provide no value to the people living in the village. Whenever we get into these games, if you take 50 grand out of the village budget for you and me and add it to the town budget for you and me, our total tax bill, which use the same checkbook to write those checks, will vary by pennies. But if you don't take it out of the village and you're charged the town, you're paying it twice for the same amount. And you can't do that by law. And when people write me emails that try to compare the town and village to two private industries, it's not the same thing, boys. It's not the same thing. Okay. I think I'm done.
Okay.
We can move on. I feel better if that's the way this thing is resolved. And what I said last week, if we outsource this now, that money goes away. That money goes to the state police, it goes to the county sheriffs, it goes to the border patrol, it goes to, and it's only $25,000. They let us know that that's not a big deal, I guess. It is, by the way, because we are all at fault when we have a tendency to say it's only pennies on the rate. $25,000 is really only pennies on the rate. $25,000 in the village is the equivalent of 20 people's full tax bill. 20 families, complete tax bill. Nobody ever thinks about it that way. It's only a few pennies. It's the complete tax bill for 20 families in the village. Now I guess I'm done.
All right.
The new 2014 Ford Flex is truly a breath of fresh air, from its stylish and bold look to its spacious and comfortable interior. The new Ford Flex definitely has a style all its own. How about this new 2014 Ford Flex SEL? It features 7-passenger seating, heated seats, sink services, and more. Right now, lease this one for 36 easy payments of just $337 a month. That's less than $12 a day. Frenchie's Ford, 216 East Orvis Street, Messina, or visit frenchiesford.com. Ford, go further.
Hi, I'm Mike Jones. We're here at StarTech Computer. We have computers, cellular telephones, and music equipment. We do repairs on most makes and models of computers, and we'd like to tell you what we got going on this week.
Smokey here from StarTech Computer, here to tell you about what has to be one of the cheapest cell phone companies around. It's $10 for 4 months with 100 minutes. That equals out to 25 minutes per month and $2.70. Now, I don't know too many cell phone companies that can compete with that. These guys have the same great coverage as one of the leading competitors in this market. So you're not going to have to worry about dead zones or call drops or any of that. And we do sell cell phones here. Some of the phones we have are like this Motorola phone. This is a flip phone. It does have a camera. It does have speakerphone. It is one of the cheaper phones we have. We also have the Motorola Razors, which are nice phones. And we sell the cards here. And we also have other plans here if you're interested. So come on down and take a look.
Supporting a green agenda, Wiley Trash Removal has been serving the community for over 40 years. Wiley Trash Removal also recycles cardboard and paper. Call 315-764-0038.
Compact money coming back. You know, what a couple of people said is, don't you guys go crazy and spend all of it. Just because you got it, you got to spend it. I think they don't realize that it's part of the compact rules and regulations and parameters and so on and so forth. The supervisor has to submit a list of the areas we are going to utilize compact money, and ostensibly it has to be for economic development. Well, how you define economic development is going to a greater or lesser degree determine how you spend that money.
One other area, let me interrupt just for a second. Economic development, or to ameliorate expenses incurred because of the impacts of the casino.
Of the casino, right.
Which would be travel on our North Rock is a prime example, right? North Rock gets a lot of traffic, people cutting over from 56 to the res. North Rock River and the east and west half, we get a lot of traffic. And so that's what we're using the compact.
Yeah, the other thing is, and you guys have heard this before from us, you cannot use that money to reduce taxes. cannot put it in your budget to reduce taxes. And Nancy keeps track very well of what we're spending the compact money on and how much. And where this is going is, we haven't had compact money for 2 years. And I think the agency that's taken the biggest hit in that is the highway department. Frank has not been able to plow or to repair, pave the number of miles that we would like to, that he would like to. And he has had to delay equipment purchases. I think in the last two budgets, Frank, we've taken vehicles and equipment, necessary equipment out. So I would, looking at what we've got and what we've projected, I would like to see that raised for the highway department, either to buy a piece of equipment. You know, Frank has to determine this. If we wanted to pave more roads, you would have to tell us the capability you have to pave the roads. You know, it's one thing to put it in, and if we can't do it, we can't do it. So as we proceed, and Nancy can, as she always does, keep track of this for us, I would like to see the amount of money allocated to the highway fund increased.
Joe's budget already has equipment in.
It has equipment.
Do you need anything more than what's in the budget?
Well, we're due for a new plow, but that was going to be something that, next year, a new plow.
Because we are expecting to have gaming compact money next year.
Yeah. We had several issues with our mower that we used for our tractor for roadsides this year. Okay.
I was glancing at on the paving schedule today, and it really looked that close. Mm-hmm. But I think plans do more next year than this year.
Mm-hmm. Well, the reason there's more in there is because of the issue what happened with, you know, the water line going to Leslie Road. That wasn't.
I understand, but we are using some money, and I believe it's mostly compact to increase your paving schedule this year over last.
Yeah.
So I think, Albert, I think it's already there in Joe's budget. I think
it's in there. I went over it with Frank.
Okay.
So 400 and some odd thousand.
480,000.
480,000 is already.
Right. So are you thinking we need to put more, or just you want you, you're just 100% supportive of what Joe has in the budget, is what you're saying?
Yes.
Okay.
And I think you're trying to explain that we can't just dump this money in general for a reason or specific purpose that we're doing.
Okay.
We're spending that money appropriately, and it's not just kicking around out later on. We're not rushing to spend it. Willy-nilly, it's being used for what it should be.
No, that's important. And the other thing is, you know, we're static with the tax decrease, but again, Chuck and I were talking at the library board meeting last night, and we had over a 20% increase in the tax rate last year. And actually, the way I look at it, I know John's the figure guy, the taxpayers are still in the hole. And it doesn't mean a lot, but I would take the $4,000 off for the raise for the council. These are part-time jobs with part-time salaries. I'm against the $4,000 raise.
Okay. $1,000.
$1,000 if you're first.
$4,000 total.
Maybe they're going to hit me over the head with a board.
My thought with the process was just the opposite.
What's that?
I thought that if we were going to get a raise, he should too.
Well, I don't dispute that. But
the 1,000.
I just have a problem.
You should get also. But,
you know, because
we should talk about that.
Last year's budget.
Put a raise in my budget.
Hit Old Man Winter with a 1-2 punch. It's time for a Fisher plow from Frenchie Chevrolet. The Fisher Extreme V plow takes efficiency and plowing to a whole new level. It features a completely redesigned blade with tapered wing design, gap coverage, high carbon steel cutting edge, and much, much more, providing you with the greater performance and reliability. Frenchie's Chevrolet, 255 East Orvis Street, Messina, your Fisher Plow headquarters in northern New York.
Fourth Coast Entertainment Magazine, published monthly, distributed throughout northern New York and surrounding areas, providing information on the arts, bands, concerts, nightclubs, recreational activities, and tourism. Online at fourthcoastentertainment.com.
Even it's me coming up.
That's why I want to get rid of
him. Because he's a typical young guy.
Just one thing, we got to keep in mind when we talk about budgets, the water line issue we have on North Racket.
Yes.
Okay, it doesn't make much sense for me to go pave that road next year if we're just going to go dig it all up. I mean, I've got other roads that I've already can tell you that I can go to and do, but we've really got to think about what we're going to do out there with that water line. You know, and how we're going to fund that.
Because of repair work that needs to be done?
Well, because it continuously breaks.
It's failed too often.
That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
So one of my parting words, whenever you guys from here on in, anybody, does a project, you get yourself a damn good inspector and have him sit right there and watch him.
Well, we all...
Because I got to say it, and I've done contracting over the years, as soon as the cat's away, the mice are going to play. And there's things that were done out there that shouldn't have been done, and we'll find out about now. It's going to be costly.
The other thing that we need to ensure is that future water lines, there's no iron pipe. Everything's fine. Everybody else is using plastic. Why don't we use plastic?
Yeah, but if you put it in the right materials, you're going to have a problem. Materials
I understand that. But,
as we go forward, we've got to decide how we're going to
start planning that.
Is it just breaking from the pressure?
This would be a classic trial for a Consolidated Water District. If we say, okay, we want to replace that water line, that's going to be a capital. We're going to have to borrow money probably to do that. If we borrow money to do that, Nancy, in a Consolidated Water District, all users now in every district will have to pay that, correct?
Everybody's currently paying a capital recovery fee.
Right.
So
additional capital, though, that we've consolidated, would be then charged to
everybody,
not just
everybody
the people.
Everybody is right now, even if they didn't have debt to begin with.
Right.
Okay.
Everybody
is now.
Recovery fee.
Okay. So.
Just the town districts, except for the Highland Road.
It's not a... No. All right. So, but this would be the first capital against the water district.
Right. And what they might have to do is, if we did have to borrow, they might have to review the amount we're collecting to see if it could...
It's enough.
Take on that extra.
But if we did have to increase that, everybody would see the increase. Correct?
Well, everybody's paying it now, so I don't. They may not see any increase. In
no, I understand. But
that money
if they
would
did,
go towards
if they
that.
Did.
And hopefully, it's an isolated problem too. It may be 200 feet, 300 feet.
No, I'm just thinking of really one of the first test cases of consolidated district. Because that would have been part of the East Messina One original district. So before the consolidation, those people would have paid
their
capital
district
costs.
Would have had to pay again.
Now everybody in the consolidated district would have to pay the cost, correct?
Yeah.
Okay.
Go ahead.
No, I got it written down, so I won't forget.
Well, if everybody's talking philosophy, let me just go over
that. I got more philosophy.
Mine is either a couple things. The casino money. One of the things that I think we need to look to as we go forward is that we start setting up some reserve funds for equipment replacement for highway, equipment replacement at the airport. There are very legitimate uses of casino
Absolutely.
Money, and then we want to keep digging into the budget every year necessarily when we need a new mower, when we need a new tractor, when we need a new plow. So I think we need to look at, if we don't set them up this year, we sure as hell need to set them up next year. We probably should set them up this year if we get some money to play with. I think we probably do with casino money. But we got a lot of this getting done on how much we spend on things like paving this year.
We can set them up with just a little bit of money.
That's what I'm saying.
We don't need to put 100 grand
in. No, exactly, right.
5,000.
5,000, 8, 7, whatever. Yeah, exactly. So that's something we need to think about.
Yeah, a lot of things.
The other thing we need to think about, I think, is looking for some increasing revenue other than tax revenue. And that's what I'm talking about when we talk about, you know, the village right now is in the process of looking at the fees they charge for fire inspection. And George and I were talking the other day too. We need to look at what we charge for fire inspection, what we charge for building permits, what we charge, any fee that we charge. I don't want to just hammer people with fees because people say it's just another tax. But if our fees are not, haven't been changed in 20 years, we need to look at some of that stuff.
I've said this before when we've talked about this before. Yeah, we're a public entity, but we're also a business. And your surrounding communities, okay, and I've done business in these surrounding communities, don't charge like the village, the town do. So there's your competition. I'm just bringing that up.
Yeah, it's a good point.
Don't charge
as much as we do.
In fees.
Well, yeah.
Well, that means the cost is just spread over taxes. Because the cost doesn't disappear.
No, I've talked about
takes somebody,
other towns.
I understand, but if somebody gets a building permit in Parrishville, somebody has to do that work, put it together, follow up on it, whatever.
That cost
is there no matter what. And okay, how are you going to pay for it? It's basically Joe's point. Are you going to pay for it with taxes, or are you going to pay for it
with money? And I think part of the discussion chart needs to be how do we line up with other municipalities?
Didn't the village just pass that?
Yeah, absolutely.
Didn't the village just pass that?
He's talking about neighboring towns, what other towns
charge. The village is one fire thing.
The fire inspection.
The other thing is our rentals. Like Chuck and I were talking to them about the BOCES, utilizing our space for nothing. And again, we made it as clear as we possibly can. We want something from them. And we picked up what? The landing fee from Cape Bear.
Yes. Yeah.
Those are things that we...
Right. And I don't disagree with what you say, Chuck. I think we need to look at what other towns charge. And we can't really look compared just to the village because for fire inspections, for example, the village has got a fire department they got to maintain and pay, right? So their needs for fire inspections may be higher than fees may be higher than we need. I don't know. But I think we should be looking at whatever fees we charge. When was the last time we curfew already? When was the last time? All right.
John started talking a long time ago.
When was the last time we increased the fees, and how do those fees? How do they stack up with what other municipalities are charging? I think that's a
super important thing. We haven't increased it that much, have we? No. Over the last 16 years,
we've talked about it over the years a couple times. There was a couple other areas that we were going to look at.
I remember Greg came back and
we changed permit fees about a half dozen years ago, didn't we?
Yeah.
We changed hanger fees.
Yeah.
4 or 5 years ago.
Since I've been here.
Dottie was still.
I think I increased the hanger fees my first year, I think.
Knows you have to stay competitive.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, and Chuck makes a point too. I don't think somebody's going to move out of the town of Messina to the town of Bridger because of a building permit. They may move over because of taxes. I think it's already happening to some extent.
But a business might.
Well, a business might. It's a good committee for you guys to do it. 14.
There you go. So I think that's something else we need to look at as we go forward with either this budget or if we can't change them overnight anyway, it's going to be local laws or like that.
Whether you're buying or selling, the Free Trader magazine is the best place to look. Place a free reader ad, call 769-7149 or visit us on the web at www.freetraderfirst.com. Free Trader Magazine, the biggest little paper in the North Country.
Come on in into Frenchie Selects right now and harvest yourself a real deal this fall on a quality select pre-owned vehicle of your choice. How about this 2012 Chevy Captiva LTZ that features all-wheel drive, leather, and much more, now just $25,900. Or check out this 2013 Chevy Cruze 2LT that features leather, power driver and passenger seats, and much more, now just $21,100. Frenchie Selects, corner of Route 37 and Parker Avenue, Messina, or visit FrenchieSelects.com.
Hi, I'm Mike Jones. We're down at StarTech at 260 East Orvis Street, right across from Frenchie Chevrolet. We have computer equipment, cellular telephones, and music equipment, and we'd like to tell you about one of the deals we got going on today.
Smokey here at StarTech Computer with the GMC Bulldozer computer package. This is a Foxconn motherboard with an AMD CPU. It has a quad-core 2.6 GHz socket AM3 processor. It's 3 gig of DDR2 RAM. It has a 500 gig SATA 3 hard drive, a DVD RW burner with LightScribe, and we're packaging this with Windows 7, a Logitech USB keyboard and mouse, and an iInk 28-inch full 1080p LCD flat panel display. This computer package has 7 cooling fans plus the CPU cooling fan, 3 of which are LED. As you can see, they're red on the case. It has 2 thermal sensors so you can keep an eye on your temperatures, and it has a vertical CD-ROM tray, and I'll show you that right now. Makes this computer very unique. The package is starting at $14.99. If you come in, we might be able to cut you a deal.
StarTech, computer, cellular, and music equipment.
The last two things I want to bring up, not really philosophical, but for your consideration as we move forward. We have 2 requests that I didn't address at all in the budget. One of them came in, I think, after the budget was done. One is the Boys and Girls Club of some sort. We need to consider that. And I think we we've got a request from the Downtown Revitalization Committee to consider that a possible use for a family development club. For comment.
What was it again?
From the Downtown Revitalization. And here's my thought on that. I'm not opposed to either of those projects. I think they're both great projects. I think we should support them. I think we need to have a formula that encourages the village to support them as well, and I'm sure they want to. And that I would go so far as to say we would do $1.50 for every dollar the village puts up. So whatever the village puts towards the Boys and Girls Club, we might consider $1.50 for each dollar they put up. So if they put up $1,000, we put up $1,500. In the same downtown. Whatever dollar the village puts up, we commit $1.50. Maybe that figure's wrong, just with something that came off the top of my head, because we've got a little more flexibility with some of the gaming compact monies than they have. But I think we both need to make commitments to these.
Again, the problem comes in with my soliloquy this morning, or at the beginning of the meeting. If they give $1,000 and we get $1,500, that thousand of our $1,500 is going to be paid by
ours will be tax dollars.
Well, but it's money that they can use though. Our 1,000 of our 1,500, approximately,
right.
Let's just say,
I see what you're saying.
Would be paid by people that already live inside the village. So the people inside the village would be paying 2,000, and the people outside would be paying 500. So I don't have any problem.
Yeah, I know what you're saying.
I just what I want to think of is if the town and village can get together on all these things and agree on a dollar amount that needs to be totally funded if we use the joint funding thought process, so that everybody pays, West Messina, because right now, think of the library again. Think of the library, something we've fought for a long time now. It is a just the town expense, right? So people that live in West Messina that are part of the village that go to the library pay nothing. They pay part of the $9,000 that Louisville pays the library. So if you live on Dover Street, if you live on the Lewis, before the $9,000, if you lived on the Louisville side of Dover Street, you paid nothing to use the library. If you lived on the town side of Dover Street, you paid a town tax to use the library. So we have to, and again, everything I'm saying leans towards consolidation thought process, okay? But if we use the joint funded model for all of these things that we think should be funded by both governments, then we'll have no issue. So if $2,500 needs to go to the Boys and Girls Club, 60% of it should come from the village, 40% of it should come from the town outside village. And we will have no issue because everybody will then be taxed at their assessment. That dollar will be based, their tax rate will be based on the assessed valuation of their home, no matter what.
And just as a sidebar, what you said, John, primarily for these two young fellows sitting in front of us, at one point in time, it used to be 60, 40 the other way. The town had much more assessed value than goes on right now.
So you had GM, you had Reynolds, you had bigger Alcoa, you had a lot of stuff.
The BDC is still 50-50.
Actually, the BDC is not your budget.
Yeah.
We're planning on giving 60,000, right?
Yeah, the village is 60.
$30,000. We gave 30.
Right. But the commitment we made was 2-year commitment of 60,000 each.
Okay.
Remember that a couple years ago?
Yeah, so hopefully they do that.
So, you're right. Well, yeah, I'm sorry, expecting they will. I think they put 30 in because we've only put 30. So, but we're going to put another 30 in this year with the compact money. At least I think we should.
Okay. Yeah, and I don't have any issues with that.
And then I think we should commit to the 60 we agreed to last year.
But again, theoretically, if we thought of all of these things under a joint funding model, which was code enforcement, it made all the sense in the world to be under a code enforcement model, recreation, BDC, all of these things. And we funded them based on assessed valuation. If the BDC needs $120,000 from the village and town, 60% should come from the village, 40% should come from the town outside village.
Can
we lend the village money? Can we give gaming compact money to the village?
Well, we sort of have. We've given it to the fire department, which is...
That's kind of what I'm saying, that I agree with what you're saying philosophically, John, and in reality. But the other reality is that because we use gaming compact money for some of these special things, town taxpayers get a break.
Inside people get breaks.
Yes, they will.
Which is the village tax? Joe.
Yeah, no, I agree with that. Right. Both of them. There is no net drag on any town taxpayer, inside or outside, when we use gaming compact for to fund some of these things.
That's right. So, NARS.
So, we are in essence, and the reason I brought up the 1.5 to 1, I think that's a way of sharing some of the casino money.
But again, Joe, the total bill that they see in the village town taxes won't matter an iota. If their town tax bill goes up or down by using that money, their village taxes go up a little bit because they don't have that money, the total that I write checks for won't change. By pennies. We play games with accounting.
So this a shell game?
It's a shell game. It keeps Nancy and, what's the village treasurer?
Julie.
Busy. Making budget, accounting transfers. But when the checks come in, they're the same. You might write a town check for $50 more one time, and $50 less for the village. You tell me how you're balancing your checkbook, it's going to be any different. It's not going to be any different. So, again, to me, it's a very, very simple thing. You have your biggest tax base when we have joint-funded things. West Messina, village residents, town outside. Everybody's included. Use that model for everything that we think we should jointly fund. That way, everybody pays their share. It's all based on assessed valuation, and nobody can bitch.
Frenchie Chevrolet has your new 2014 Chevrolet and the lease deal you've been waiting for. Check out this real deal. Check out this new 2014 Chevy Equinox LS that features all-wheel drive, CD, MP3, power driver's seat, gets an estimated 29 miles per gallon highway, and much more. Right now, lease this one for 39 easy payments of just $272 a month. That's less than $10 a day. Frenchie Chevrolet, 255 East Orvis Street, Messina, or visit FrenchieChevy.com. Chevrolet, find new roads.
There's always something going on at St. Lawrence Center. What brings you to St. Lawrence Center? I love all the products and entertainment too. What brings you to St. Lawrence Center? Their prices are affordable. It's my favorite place to go to have lunch. There's always something going on at St. Lawrence Center.
I'm Mike Jones. We're down at StarTech at 260 East Orvis Street, right across from Frenchie Chevrolet. We have computer equipment, cellular telephones, and music equipment, and we'd like to tell you about one of the deals we got going on today.
And here we have a beautiful Epiphone Dot Studio guitar. This is like a lower grade version of a 335 Gibson. Great for blues, jazz. This is actually Smokey's favorite guitar here in the store. Catch him playing all kinds of blues. And the out-of-tune Beatles tuning. How's that? I will tune it if you buy it. This guitar is going for... Last I remember, I think it was $300. So come in, I may give you a special deal on this one as well.
StarTech, where we make things work for you.
Anytime you do it any other way, somebody's gonna bitch.
Okay, Star, your turn.
I like your vocabulary.
It's to the point. What I would like, Albert, you and I had a discussion the other day about trying to, and that's why I asked for fund balance information, Nancy, which, as all you've seen, has dropped considerably over the last few years. So here's something that I'm going to ask with compact money. Can we do this to help build our fund balance? I think I already know the answer, but I think I've asked this question before, Nancy. Okay, compact money is for economic development, right? That airport, in my mind, is absolute economic development.
Sure. Absolutely.
So, I don't know, wait for the reaction off her face when I say this. Why can't we take the operating budget, or a portion of it, or a good share of it, and take it right out of the town tax payers, or whoever's paying, everybody pays for that.
Right.
Right out of the compact money. A good portion of it. Can can that, that first question is, can we do that? Because in my mind, that airport's economic development, absolutely. I know we're paying grants and all that sort of thing off of there, et cetera, et cetera. But what that does is that helps that frees Frank's budget up. But his salaries for those individuals, or however we decide, this is a conceptual thing. However, if we could do it, then you can go start paving roads someplace else besides what's on the eastern end of the township.
When you're taking what Joe put in his budget from the compact money to the highway fund, and you're adding the airport to that, you're taking a huge chunk out of that compact
money. I didn't say you'd take it off.
I didn't say you were going to take it off. No matter what you're putting in there, no matter what you're proposing to put in there, you're taking a big chunk out of that compact money.
I think, Chuck, you're assuming that it's both general fund. Like, if you're saying instead of putting the compact money in the roads, put it at the airport, and that would free up the money for the roads. But DB is outside. That's where chips and roads are done.
Yeah. I knew better.
That's.
I think I've asked this question.
That's where some of the accounting games is important.
I think smart.
But again, we want to be very careful about picking. Same thing's true with us versus what I was saying in town and village. You know, moving dollars out of one fund into another fund may be a nice budget trick for that fund. Ultimately, it's not going to change the rate one bit. It's not going to change the bill that the taxpayer gets.
So it gets the job done. It needs to be done. The roads need to be
all done. But we can do that no matter what we want to do by doing budget transfers. We do budget transfers all during the year.
Okay.
So we can. So all I'm saying is, we need to do the best at the beginning of the year on setting up budget amounts the best we can. But we don't. I'm saying we don't really need to be perfect because we can transfer funds between budget funds as long as they're legal transfers. Now, another thing I was going to say along your idea, though, is airport grant funding that our portion, I would think, would absolutely fit into the game.
That's already And that's what we got short when we didn't receive the compact money because we had to pay our bills.
Right.
Our percentage of that.
Our percentage until the compact money.
And that's a big caveat, too, gentlemen, is whatever we remove from the budget and cover with casino money. Mm-hmm. If someday the casino money's not there, like last year it wasn't, then the taxes go through the roof. Yeah. And God forbid the Canadians open a casino in Cornwall. What's going to happen to our compact revenue? You know, I mean, it's probably not going to happen, but I'm just saying. That's what scares me about taking things out of the budget, using casino money to supplant it.
Okay.
Because you have the potential there to be a huge gaping hole if at some point the casino money dries up.
Okay, let me show you.
Go ahead, Chuck. No, go ahead.
Okay.
I'll write it down so I don't
forget. All right. Another idea I have with the compact money, and you and I talked about this many, many years ago before we had compact money. Is it legal? Can we create, we're talking about making some money, right? Can we create a revolving fund? For an example, entity comes to us and they've got some good that fits in the parameters of the compact money project. They say, yeah, okay, we'll lend you that money and we'll charge you 5%. Can we do that?
I think the town of Brazier did something like that, or was going to do something like that, but they need an agency to maintain it.
And we have an agency.
And they were going to contract with the BDC to maybe do that. I think Gary put that in a couple of his budgets that we would create a revolving loan fund.
I think that's something that needs to be looked at and done because there's a lot of projects, we got a lot of money right now, okay? And it might be a little, because of the parameters, this particular year might be difficult to earmark that money. But next year we might have four really good projects that need to be done, and then we don't have the money.
We really don't have that much money, people think.
We don't.
That 987.
Back out what we spent.
Gone. A lot. You gave us a, you gave us a, our gaming contract, our gaming compact money goes to the general fund.
Right. Well, what happened, what I tried to do, and what I tried to do this year was to make sure that the people outside did not have to pay an extra rate like they did in 2013. So if there were economic development issues that we could, that were legitimate, that we could use the money to offset that fund, B and DB, that's what I did.
Right.
So we don't have an outside tax rate higher this year. It's this, and people don't understand it when they sign the paper, well, people that live outside tax rate went down this much, people that live in the village only went down this much. They don't understand that the people outside paid an additional tax for 2013 that they hadn't paid at all, plus the increase that the people inside pay as well. So that's why I try to put all that stuff, you know, I try to cover all that stuff with compact first.
Right.
And make sure that outside doesn't have an additional tax. So then if there's excess left over, and I disagree with what everybody says about economic development with compact money, the law clearly says you can use it for economic development to offset the cost of education about gambling addiction. The rest goes in your general fund. That's what the law says. It does not say you have to use it all for economic development.
Well, right.
So in the sheet you gave us, you're projecting a $1.4 million net fund balance.
Right. At the end of this year.
That's general fund?
Yes.
Just general fund.
That's general fund, because that's our biggest one.
Right.
So, compact money is in your right now?
Yes.
We have some compact, well, we got the 900.
We received a check for $987,000. It's in the bank.
We've already spent some of it, because we said if we got it, we would buy, pay the equipment that Frank needed,
right,
and pay for some different things. And then we're allocating some for the 2014 budget, because now it's in fund balance.
Right. So whatever we're allocating for next year's budget comes out of the $1.4 million that you show here.
It's
general
already,
fund.
Yes, it's already taken out.
It's
of
already
there.
Taken out?
Yeah. Of what we were going to spend in 13, not 14.
In 13.
Yes.
So 14, we're going to have $1.4 million at the end of this year, mm-hmm, minus any A fund balance that we use in next year's budget.
Right.
Correct? Mm-hmm. And we're using some?
Yes, 300, I think.
300,000. So our fund balance starting theoretically in January will be 1.1 million.
Yes.
So we don't have as much money as some people think.
No, that's only
we're not sure. It's
about 3 months worth of expenses.
Right. Right. So.
Okay.
It's not huge.
Anyways, I brought up an idea.
But we do probably have, again, going back to everybody wanting to set up reserves, and I think that's a great idea. And again, we don't have to put $100,000 in all the reserve funds. We could put $5,000 in all these reserve funds, get something started, and go year by year on what you put into it.
While we're talking about it, I'll go back to my pets. Two of my pets. The legacy cost for retirement and sick days.
Oh, I thought it said licensing cats. It's legacy cost. Oh. I thought I put that in good enough height of so you take that and go over. I was hoping you'd start that off.
Anyways, that's another fund that we've talked about before, and I tried to find that sheet. I couldn't find it on my hard drive on my computer. Nancy gave us that information where we don't know when our staff is going to retire, but there are costs there that are related with their retirements. We don't have any money put away. Example, when our maintenance person from the library retired unexpectedly, we had to come up with a pile of money quick.
Same with the highway superintendent, former highway superintendent.
So, you know, again, that's a fund I think that we better set up. I mean, last year we couldn't do it, but I think we need to set that up, and you got to start putting some money there, because, and then, while we're talking about funds, retirement costs are going to be what this year, 3% or next year, 3% or whatever it is?
I think it's just 3% increase, which isn't too bad.
Okay. I can remember
and that's
years.
That's projected, because you're always working with big salaries that are a couple years back,
right,
because that's how they base their figures.
Right.
Because the retirement this year that we have to pay at the end of 2013 is actually less than what we budgeted. So.
Well, my point is, and I sat on this board, I sat there and I looked at the numbers. We weren't paying hardly anything in when I first started as a town councilman. We were paying a very little amount of money for retirement. And then bang, 2008 happened, and now everybody hates anybody in public employment because their retirement fund's better than anyone else. My point is, I brought it up a couple years ago, and I'll bring it up again, another fund. It's going to happen again. You need to put some money away to smooth over those retirement costs when they go up again. They're going to spike. If Congress keeps doing what they're doing and the stock market takes a dive, in 2 years we're going to see a spike. Right, Nancy, if say it all spiked. Because we're tied in, the retirements are tied into the stock markets. So again, those are the funds, John, that I think we ought to set up. It's for legacy costs, for retirement,
They're tied into the stock market, but the comptroller's office made a lot of changes since 2008 in the funds that they invest.
Oh, yeah.
They're not as risky as they used to be.
Well, yeah, okay. But my point
is, a downturn, no matter how you look at it, would hurt it, but hopefully not.
It doesn't have to be a lot of money, but if you got a little bit. Anyways, those three things, you know, legacy costs for people retire, increase in retirement, and the sick days and those types of things. So,
I'll have to do a little research for you because at one point I recall them saying that the comptroller's office, that you could not set money aside for people's retirement. Because you're sort of budgeting for the future, and towns are supposed to budget year to year. I know it sounds stupid, but when you raise the taxes, you're supposed to come out to zero. You're not supposed to have fund balance. You're not supposed to have minus balances. You're supposed to raise what you need to operate and go year to year.
It's totally makes no sense. Because if you don't do budget projections, if you don't do multi-year budgeting, which we don't do, everybody should, you do it at your house. Yeah. See, I'm going to need a new roof next year, I'm going to need a new siding 5 years from now, whatever. You know, if you're out in the country, I'm going to need a new well, I need a new septic. Everybody in a household budgets multi-year. So it only makes sense if a municipality should be able to budget multi-year. And don't forget, look, the comptroller doesn't make laws. They interpret things. And they make recommendations, and they can whack us in an audit. They really can't do a whole lot to experience.
These vehicles look brand new right off the showroom floor, but they're not. They've been detailed by Final Touch Detailing. If you can drive it, Final Touch can detail it. Trucks, boats, cars, and bikes. It's time to think about getting your vehicle ready for the winter weather. Well, Final Touch Detailing can take care of you. Their services include wash, including undercarriage and engine compartment, vacuum shampoo and steam clean, Scotchgard treatment for fabric, leather treatment, wax and buffing, and much more. Get that car show quality detailing today with Final Touch Detailing. Call 842-9810. That's 842-9810. Or email odie7342@yahoo.com.
The new 2014 Ford Focus sedan is your friend at the pump and your love on the road. The new Focus is driving dynamics at its best. And if you're looking for fuel economy, then this is your car. How about this new 2014 Ford Focus sedan? It features Sync Voice activated services, 6-speed automatic transmission, gets an estimated 37 miles per gallon highway and more. Right now, lease this one for 36 easy payments of just $179 a month. Frenchie's Ford, 216 East Orvis Street, Messina, or visit frenchiesford.com. Ford, go further.
Hi, I'm Mike Jones. We're here at StarTech Computer. We have computers, cellular telephones, and music equipment. We do repairs on most makes and models of computers, and we'd like to tell you what we got going on this week. Hi, down at StarTech Music, we have a complete line of student band instrument rentals. We've got saxes, clarinets, violins, trombones, trumpets, drums. We have violins, saxes, clarinets, drums, trombones, trumpets, and violins, saxes, clarinets, trumpets, trombones, and more. If you're interested in band instrument rental, the first payment covers the first 3 months. If your student decides to keep playing, all of the rental money is applied towards the purchase. If the student decides not to keep playing, you return the instrument and owe nothing. StarTech, where we make things work for you.
I have money in the bank. Yeah. I'll shut up for a while. There's a lot of things I want to talk about, but I'll let you guys talk.
Well, this is our night.
Oh, it's our night.
You said that we're dancing. Would be our... If we didn't have anything, we'd have Frankie. Let him. And then we would try to figure out who wants to come, who we should schedule for the next 2 weeks.
I was wondering if I could just add something to the taxes. We did have that issue out on the Cary Road. I'm fully aware of it, and I forgot to write it on the front of the tentative budget. We're going to add $1,453.64 to the people, whoever it is that owns the Cary Road property. I have to show it as another tax on the tentative tax projection that we prepare. Just, and it's only going to be paid by whoever the property owner is. But I have to still show it on there.
Okay.
I didn't. So I would like to just change that for next,
okay.
Next time.
Up at the 18 and then we'll call it even.
I thought 14 was bad enough, the amount of garbage they had.
Oh, it is bad.
Do you want to talk about Frank's budget?
Sure. If we have anything else,
3 years
back. Let's talk about highway.
The museum board does want to meet. And if they said it would be short, and I suggested possibly before a regular meeting next week, because they said it'd be short. So they want to talk about the $2,200.
$2,200 they didn't get?
Yeah, well, $2,200 that.
What are their balance?
Well, talking with Joe, my brother, today, they were a little concerned about people, about why. It looked like they were going to overspend their budget this year. And then after the meeting, he realized, well, geez, it's easy. They put that sound system in this year. That's not going to be an ongoing expense.
Right.
You take away that, they would easily, met their budget.
And I kind of think that's why our projection was a little lower, because we took historic data that they never really spent.
No, they haven't. That's what we kind of convinced them of last year.
Yeah.
And they left here happy. So they can still come next week, but I think Joe's already got the answer.
I don't think too many people left happy last year.
It probably wouldn't be bad for them to come.
Sure.
It should be a quick short thing. Yeah, that's fine.
The library says they want to come, right?
Library wants to come the 25th.
When did BDC say they? When did
same day.
He said the 23rd. Right?
23rd, is it?
Yes, I think so.
Yeah. All right. Now, 6
guys,
5 o'clock, right?
Next week's
5 o'clock. 5 o'clock,
and then 5:30.
All right. I'll email them
to
come show
up.
BDC
wants to come.
BDC,
I got
library and Dino. He's been out of
the room. Back in that
room. I'm sorry. Where is it? It must be in
Okay.
Yeah, the rescue squad here, maybe. He knows when they want.
Do you have a preference?
Well, we got to wait until we approve the budget by ourselves, and that's
when do you do that?
Monday night.
All right.
So you can come the day of the board meeting? Regular board meeting?
Or rescue squad, this should be pretty quick and easy.
Rescue squad.
Yeah.
Are you going to have any issues with us? You never do.
I haven't heard.
You never ever come to our budget sessions, do you?
Well, I used to.
We have.
If you want to, yeah. If you want to, you can come next week. We'll start at 5. And we'll do the museum. If the rescue squad needs to come, we'll do the rescue squad too. Should we get Meals on Wheels here then? Do they want to come, or they request it?
I sent letters and I haven't heard back.
Okay, well, we'll hear from them.
But I did say in the letter that, you know, we would schedule, so.
Yeah, okay. So we have to follow up with the calls, you mean?
So. Get too many on our board then.
No, I agree. I don't want them.
That's gonna be.
I'm saying, I'm thinking if we get Hockery out on the 23rd, let's go out Hockery out the 23rd, then we don't have to have the 30th.
Okay, Meals on Wheels on the 23rd.
If they want to come, go.
Humane Society, they can match you. Humane Society can.
Humane Society, yeah, they want to come with.
Do you want them on the 23rd as well?
Sure.
And I think the seniors want.
Senior citizens.
You want them on the 23rd? So far you have, you would have BDC, the library, Meals on Wheels, and Humane Society.
Right. Seniors, they want to really fuss out some.
We could probably do the seniors on the 16th.
That's what I'm thinking.
The seniors want to come too? For $500?
Mm-hmm.
It's a lot of bingo chips.
We think.
Well, hey, the request was more than, the request was what, $7,000? Senior citizens.
Yeah, I can't remember.
I have it right here. Let's see. Seniors asked for $5,000 and we gave them $4,200. And they got $3,613.
So $800 different.
So they're getting $600 more than this year.
What'd you say?
And $800 less than they requested.
And we paid the director's salary too.
And the director requested $7,000 salary and we granted $6,357.
That's the number I was thinking of.
That's your first.
Yes.
And then that going out by Gus Blazes here.
Yeah, I know.
And Chamber of Commerce is, they're not, their difference is only $500, so I don't know.
Yeah, they had asked for more, but we put in the summer help.
Yeah, they asked for 10 and 5, and we gave them 10 and 4,500.
So.
It's only $500.
Right. I think they'll be happy with that.
They may be fine with that.
I do too.
Joe?
Yes.
I want to remind you about the fire protection. I don't know if you have on that committee that you need, but we need to come to.
Churches is your bang up job of law enforcement, maybe you need to first. I mean, code enforcement, you need to do fire protection too.
No, not.
Because we need to set a public hearing.
Yes, I know, yeah.
What do you need a budget for? All they gotta do is have a hose of water, that's all.
They,
No, I drink that.
Right down.
I'm staying from that.
All right.
Frankie, you got anything?
Oh, we're good.
Have any standpoint?
Any questions for me? I mean.
Do you have any issues with your, the budget Joe gave you?
Crunchy Chevrolet has your new 2014 Chevrolet and the lease deal you've been waiting for. Check out this real deal. Check out this new 2014 Chevy Cruze LTZ that features a power sunroof, Pioneer audio sound system, remote start, and much more. Right now, lease this one for 39 easy payments of just $239 a month. That's less than $8 a day. Frenchie's Chevrolet, 255 East Orvis Street, Messina, or visit FrenchieChevy.com. Chevrolet, find new roads.
These vehicles look brand new right off the showroom floor, but they're not. They've been detailed by Final Touch Detailing. If you can drive it, Final Touch can detail it. Trucks, boats, cars, and bikes. It's time to think about getting your vehicle ready for the winter weather. Well, Final Touch Detailing can take care of you. Their services include wash, including undercarriage and engine compartment, vacuum shampoo and steam clean, Scotchgard treatment for fabric, leather treatment, wax and buffing, and much more. Get that car show quality detailing today with Final Touch Detailing. Call 842-9810. That's 842-9810. Or email odie7342@yahoo.com.
Mike Jones. We're down at StarTech at 260 East Orvis Street, right across from Frenchie Chevrolet. We have computer equipment, cellular telephones, and music equipment. And we'd like to tell you about one of the deals we got going on today. Here we have an Insonic VFX SD synthesizer. Regular $399, but say you saw this on WNTS TV, come on down, $50 off. Take it home, play all your favorite songs.
StarTech, where we make things work for you.
You know, like my only concern is obviously is North Racket. What are we going to do there? I mean, I've got plenty of other roads that I can pave. We got to decide, and we need to get working on that here. When we get through the budget, we plan that all out. What are we going to do?
If we don't say we postpone the work that needs to be done on North Racket, mm-hmm. are you going to have to go out and put a lot of money in repairs just like you did before?
Well, the road is going to need, if you put a water line, the road's going to need some repairs. Right. So, I mean, there's no way you're going to get around that.
Okay.
But that should be included in the cost of replacing the water.
Well, I'm saying until we get to that point in time.
Maybe some greater action.
Okay, from a budgeting standpoint, that's what we're talking about. That would be, again, a project.
Yes.
Capital project, yeah. Probably. Capital project probably requiring engineering. Mm-hmm. Capital project probably requiring bonding. Mm-hmm. All right. Do we already have enough money in the existing budget that Joe put together that would cover our 2014 costs to get the engineering, the bidding, and all that done?
I don't have that money.
The water project would come out of the water fund.
Okay, so then, do we have enough? That's true.
So it would come out of the maintenance.
So none of this affects our budget.
It wouldn't affect, it's just the road is what he's talking about.
But what we need to, we need to move it along.
I would think we would, yes, we need to move along. But I would think whether we repave that road next year after we do the water line, or in 15, we still, combat money's an extra cover anyway.
Yes.
The paving. And that shouldn't, I
don't if you don't do that road, you do another road.
That's
next
right.
year.
We're not going
to so the dollar amount's already there.
I know where to go. There's two places I go if I don't get North Racket.
Right.
Yeah. We haven't really talked about damages either.
Yeah.
Our damages as a result of the inferior, what we think is inferior work.
So will somebody be held accountable for that?
They probably already passed whatever
we have to sue something.
Well, unless we can prove malfeasance, we have to sue.
We'd have to sue.
Or if we determine it was shoddy workmanship, then we have to sue somebody.
We also would have to decide on whether who we're going to use for our engineering firm to do this.
Yeah.
Better get
another one.
I
hate to say that.
Yeah.
That would be Paris. Paris did that water line.
They didn't do the engineering, though.
They did the stuff.
Yes.
Shoddy workmanship is what you said. Paris did that.
It all depends on what the engineer.
Berlin Herminiac to the engineer.
Yes.
What did they put in the specs?
Right. No, I understand. Yeah.
So,
I understand.
So the workmanship might have been fine. The specs may have been a problem.
Yeah.
Exactly. Or
vice versa. Right. I mean, it's needs to be determined.
What about Leslie Road? Where we at with Leslie? We completed the repairs this week. We're going as of yesterday.
Is that going to have to be repaved shortly?
That's one of the roads I put into repave next year. We got 516 ton of asphalt back into that road for patches. And $27,000 worth of material.
That came out of your budget?
Yep, which I told you I'll be over on my...
None of it came from the village water budget, correct?
No.
Okay.
I thought about, maybe we could take it from the water fund, but then I thought, oh geez, they're not in the water district, so I can't charge the water district.
They belong to the village water department.
I think we should call that even.
A long time ago.
We shouldn't call that even with the airport.
They made the repairs to the driveways, to the lawns.
I didn't think of that.
Said stuff like that, Frank Nels, last week.
You're gonna have to repeat that. The village made the repairs to the lawns, the driveways, and where the water line, you know, ran through the yard, took care of all that part. And they actually, I'll give them credit, Steve, you know, Daly and his crew helped us out tremendously, or we'd still be there. They cut the road for us and removed the, you know, the damaged pavement, and we paved them behind them. I don't know how we would've got it done, because we're, you know, we should be hauling sand right now and getting ready for.
None of it should've been your job, Frank.
I understand, we got it.
So don't.
It's done. I mean, it's plowable, and the residents have a road that is usable.
Yeah, you did more than you needed to do.
Well, the town made the offer.
I understand, but the guy did his job.
What's happening?
The village water, Steve Daly works for the village water department.
What, I mean, we offered to do what we did out there, and what we didn't think, none of us thought about the.
Well, that's why, it's really key, if you're working together with the village and town on a project, this, there really should be a meeting where we sit down as a group and say, okay, when the road gets damaged, how we take care of that?
We need a standing committee at town.
You need a pre-construction meeting, really, I mean, decide how it's all gonna be handled.
Right.
And this thing was, unless the road project was done under less than ideal circumstances, let's be honest, the whole thing back and forth, how it's gonna cost, who's gonna pay for it.
But the people are happy, they got clean water.
Yeah, that's the bottom line, right? People get better water, but it's really not a clinic and the way to do a project the most efficient way, that's for sure.
Because I still have to, there's some work that I need to do in our own parking lot or the garage, it's desperately needed to be paved, which I gotta do, which is gonna put me over the, you know, the money's just not there, but.
This year, you gotta do that.
Yeah, I gotta pave it. We're falling through the pavement when we pull in the spring, you know, in the winter season, when we have a thaw. We gotta take and pave it. It's a section behind behind the garage where the overhead doors are. We started working on that, and obviously we got pulled off of that because of going to the Leslie Road.
So you're saying you're gonna overspend 2013 budget?
I was gonna overspend no matter.
Okay, how do we do handling that? You have transfers?
Yeah.
What did you just say? We budgeted more than we spent, what was that you just said?
Well, in the DB fund, I think we would end up having to go to the fund balance. So it may affect what I'm predicting, because.
For the end of the year.
Yeah, I mean, I look at what we have for expenditures, what we spent so far, I try to estimate what I think the rest of the expenses are gonna be. So it's gonna be a bit more, but what did I say for?
1.4.
Fourth Coast Entertainment Magazine, published monthly, distributed throughout northern New York and surrounding areas, providing information on the arts, bands, concerts, nightclubs, recreational activities, and tourism. Online at fourthcoastentertainment.com.
Come on into Frenchie Selects right now and harvest yourself a real deal this fall on a quality select pre-owned vehicle of your choice. Here is what you've been waiting for, a 2013 Chevy Volt that features leather heated seats and much more, now just $34,500. Or check out this 2011 Chevy Silverado 1500 LT extended cab truck that features a powerful 5.3-liter V8 engine and much more, now just $26,900. Frenchie Selects, corner of Route 37 and Parker Avenue, Messina, or visit FrenchieSelects.com.
Hi, I'm Mike Jones. We're here at StarTech Computer. We have computers, cellular telephones, and music equipment. We do repairs on most makes and models of computers, and we'd like to tell you what we got going on this week.
Well, here we have the whole guitar performance package. We have a Strat-style guitar with an amplifier. It comes with a tuner, picks, guitar strap, and a cord, and even an instructional DVD so you can learn how to play guitar. This package here is great for gifts or just for anyone who wants to start out. This is going for $299, but again, if you come in and say that you saw this ad, somebody's calling already. You can get this for $249. A great deal.
StarTech, where we make things work for you.
The garage is EA.
Yeah.
Everybody pays for that. Okay. So I think we said to the question over here, is that DB or DB? I'm
not sure. See, I just refuse a reference. The names of these budgets.
Yes, John, we hear that every year.
The library should be L, highway yes. should be H.
Library is
the L. Library is the only one that makes sense, you're right. Highway should be H, but no, it's D and B, B, A, D, A, A, B, C, J, K, L. It's no sense.
I just turned to Frank and said, why are you D, A, and B, B? He goes, duh.
Why not change it?
It's a state. We can't. They all cover. No, we all. I want to do away with all these stupid letters.
So you should approach the legislature and
yeah, I know. It's so effective there, so far.
I came to Nancy, obviously, about a week ago because I was concerned. I said, you know, give me a snapshot of where I am. There was only about $15,000 left in that. And I said, well, I know I'm going to be over.
So we are predicting right now $253,000 at the end of the year, and that's not including any of those things that he's giving me. And we're not appropriating anything in DB for 2014, so I think we'll be okay. We can take it from one balance.
Because that's why I came to you a month and a half ago. I knew this is probably going to put me over, you know.
Well, that Leslie Rose should not be. I mean, he can't help
that. Well, that's why we before we do any of that stuff, we have to talk about it, because if we don't have fund balance, you can't do it. Yeah. I don't care if you need to do it or not, you can't do it. If there's no money to spend, you can't do it.
But then the road was, I understand.
We've never been in that position, Frank. I'm just saying that's why those things have to come to us.
Can I have the conversation on the paving?
Sure.
I know that when I asked for cable out of the Frito Road, I also let you know I was looking into some funds from the federal government. The Seaways actually tore that road up terribly in the last 3 or 4 years. They had to have trucks with their road grindings running for a whole month back and forth. And I know that we started working out there, and I thought maybe that was the start of it anyway.
Well, it's patching and fixing.
I've been told that there may be some federal money. There's another road that the Border Patrol is running, I think, closer to Lake Ontario, and they're providing funds for that as well. I'm not sure if that area is, you know, in the budget for next year, but there might be some federal money available. But I'm assuming that I may be pursuing that, you know, once I'm on the board. Okay. And I just, you know, if there is maybe a 75%, 25%, it'd be nice to see that we would have some money available. If we get money out of the federal, it'd be nice to have the funds available here. To
Everyone's economic development goes right down to the Seaway, right?
Yeah, right. And it does get a lot of heavy truck traffic.
Definitely.
But I'd like to have the money available if we, you know, if we can't get the whole thing. I'd like to have the money available to do the project.
Yeah. Which means taxes on your road, that's all good.
Why would be?
Better do it for January.
There you go.
A lot of the work we did out there this year was because we had a water issue in the winter time.
Yeah.
And we discovered as we were doing it that large culvert that runs across the road was pretty much ready to go. Was ready to let go, sink in, so we had to replace that. Those things you come across me doing, so.
Okay.
On the highway, Frank.
Yep.
I'm trying to find your jokes. I think I highlighted it. But in here somewhere, you dropped. Somewhere's in the narrative. And you dropped some money for snow removal. Is that correct?
The personnel side.
Right, overtime. Right?
Based on historical data.
Because we're using as much for plowing as we have that.
Well, every year we look at that, right? Based on.
Right.
Did we, speaking of personnel, did we budget any additional personnel funds knowing that we're going through a new contract?
Yes.
Okay.
Frank, how much, I can't find it here. How much did you drop it? What did you drop?
I actually took W-2s.
Yeah.
And then I estimated what their, took the base pay. We estimated the overtime at 175 hours for each person. Plus they get a call-in, what do they call it?
They get call-in pay.
Some kind of, that little 65-cent thing. Longevity, an estimated pay increase, and it still didn't come up to what we had budgeted because we spread their salaries across several different areas. We totaled them all up, and so I asked Frank, where would you rather see me drop it? General repair or spring or snow removal? He felt snow removal.
Because we burned through the general repair. We're burned through it already, and it's not even November.
And historical data, we haven't had a hard winter in several years.
No.
But we still have plenty, even if we do. We budget quite a bit in there.
So you're comfortable that if we get a hard winter, like you're going to be all right. Because I worry more about that because I know what happened where I grew up. They didn't. They wouldn't let them keep the money, and they got pounded, and they didn't have money to store.
We do have other. We have personnel line items and other funds that nobody says that just because you're working. Hauling snow, you have to charge snow.
Okay.
You could charge.
As long as you think you can handle a major.
We can make interfund transfers. Yeah.
You don't even have to do that. You just charge it to that. Charge the salary for that line item.
The almanac's predicting hard winter. It's the same almanac predicting the dry summer. And I mow my lawn every 3 days in summer. So that's how much
snow. Stop raining. Should we consider last winter a hard winter?
No. I come from down around Oswego and had it down here. You guys don't even know.
Amen.
where are we with the garage?
Nowhere.
$2.5 million. That's where we're at with the garage.
And rising.
And it's a new garage.
Anyway,
that's the shell.
No, that's complete.
It's
building a new garage in the location adjacent to us. With different versions of, do we have village water? If we don't have village water, we got to put in a system because of fire protection, so there's different costs. And
are we the GC? Do we have the outside GC? All those guys.
So I guess maybe somewhere along the line, this board, I would assume, we're going to have to make a decision when they're in that garage.
It'll be a capital project.
Any CapEx money be used in that?
Sure, Dawson's using a whole pile of prisoner.
You could use it for some of your bonding payments.
I would think so.
Okay.
But I think the bigger point here, Chuck, is, and Frank and I have talked about this, if we're going to do it, the rates are going to be lower if we're going to borrow $2.5 million to build a new town garage.
I agree.
So if we're going to do it, we're going to do it.
I got something else written. I'll have to find it.
And the other thing is, what we haven't talked about in a while is upgrading security in our buildings. That's out there too. We've gotten several, I've gotten information and shared information. And, I've got NCC revisiting their actual estimation again to give it back to us. But, I don't know.
How much was that? About 30, 40?
Last one, because we added the library and the museum, we were probably up around 60,000.
60.
The other thing that we somehow slipped through the cracks on the project for the town hall We didn't put an automatic door for handicap access at the police station. So we got an inclusive.
That should be.
Should be.
It's a door opener and a couple of buttons.
At the least. Could be a new door. So it should be $10,000.
But I think we still have money in our, in the grants that we have for here to cover that anyway.
Yeah, we said we got way a little bit.
Any questions, I mean, for me on the highway? I don't have any, I mean.
I got one someplace, but I wrote it down. I didn't do a real good job putting it how I come over with my notebook all.
Yeah, I don't have any concerns. It's significantly higher than last year.
And the big part of that is.
Two of the big equipment items that you've been held back on for a while, you're going to be able to get this year. You're doing more roads this year than you had last year. So it's all real positive as far as I can see.
Is your budget really that good, Nancy? Is your budget really that good?
It's your budget.
No, well, our budget.
It's your budget.
Just so everybody knows, we're going to, obviously, we're scheduled to do the North Racket, but that's something to change. So we either have a LaRue Road I can do, and or we can do the other end of the North Racket, we call from 37C to 37, and then the Haverstock, that other end of it.
Hook in there.
Yeah, depends on which, what road looks the worst in the spring. With South Grass River Road, and it's basically 900 feet of the Highland Road, where I call it the old Fabric Bazaar, where we started cutting the road, and around Leslie Road back out to Highland. That's the plan.
How much traffic does the Taylor Road get? Have we ever done a counter on that road?
Taylor Road?
Yeah.
We haven't done that road.
We don't know. What do we call it? The scene end of it? Still the Taylor Road, yeah. Goes from the South Racket Road to Brazier Center.
Change his name, but to Brazier
Center. I think
it's not our road.
It's not our road.
Well, part of it is. The Messina portion is.
Very, very close to our line. Not much of it.
No, it's not half a mile much. Maybe. It's pretty rough.
Turns into the Taylor Road.
No.
Turns into the Taylor Road. Kind of
go around the underneath the power lines, and that first road on the right by the old schoolhouse, that's the Taylor Road.
There's not much of the town of Messina, but it's pretty rough. What's there is pretty rough.
I guess I don't know where it is.
Is it off the South Racket?
Yeah.
South. Near the railroad tracks, you bear right?
Yes.
Yeah, you go around the big curve.
That's 37. That's County Road 37.
County Road 37, you're right.
County Road. County Road.
No, it's off the County Road 37.
It's up there. That's Lewis.
That's Brazier. One side of that road's Brazier.
Part of it is the town of Messina. No.
It's not on our listing.
No.
I'm telling you, Brazier Town Line is.
It's the county road.
But I know what you're talking about
it's
now.
It's off the county road.
Joe, the Taylor Road is not listed on our miles.
But we have, there is part of it is in the town of Messina.
No, I don't know.
Take it right out there and see what the town line is.
Okay.
Well,
nope.
Rachel
knows that. No. Well, I guess it's just like the Quinnell Road. Half the Quinnell Road is ours and half the Quinnell Road is in Brazier.
Right, exactly.
So, but we plow that and Brazier doesn't.
Certified Public Accountant. We here at this office will prepare income tax returns for businesses and individuals. So if you have a C corporation, an S corporation, even partnerships and sole proprietors, we can take care of your tax needs. At the office, we can prepare your payroll and bookkeeping needs. We offer full bookkeeping services and full payroll services, as well as assistance with preparing your payroll quarterlies and sales tax returns.
into Frenchie Selects right now and harvest yourself a real deal this fall on a quality select pre-owned vehicle of your choice. Here is what you've been waiting for, a 2013 Chevy Volt that features leather heated seats and much more, now just $34,500. Or check out this 2011 Chevy Silverado 1500 LT extended cab truck that features a powerful 5.3-liter V8 engine and much more, now just $26,900. Frenchie Selects, corner of Route 37 and Parker Avenue, Messina, or visit FrenchieSelects.com.
StarTech, located at 260 East Orvis Street, Messina, New York. Serving the community for 26 years. StarTech, an official Sprint dealer, carries computers and accessories, software and devices you need to enhance your computing experience. Our trained technicians can repair or custom build your system. StarTech also carries a variety of musical instruments as well as school band instruments. That's StarTech for all your technical needs.
I just know where it's located. It's a schoolhouse right there.
There used to be an old schoolhouse right there on the left.
That's what it is. It's named after the Taylor family.
What's we used to go to the circus there?
Yeah, the circus used to be there too.
Yeah, that's right. The circus was there. Yeah.
Some other
event
there.
Yes, sir. Okay, Frank. Okay. Any questions about the airport budget?
Got a hell driver. That's for sure. Remember the hell driver?
Yep.
They're pretty cool.
The $20,000 that's in here is for a new mower.
Focus.
Yep. it's going to be pretty much like the Ferris. I think we bought the Ferris 2 years ago.
It's an A5.
Oh, yeah, there's
a
nice new
mower.
Looks good.
Glancing down through 2013 to 14, you basically have some inflation adjustments. The $20,000 for the mower.
Yep. And as I learn more about the airport, there's two items, and I don't know how they were being accounted for, but telephone services and miscellaneous. I could not find out from last year's budget where those were in the budget at all, so that's why I put those in there.
Okay.
So that's another,
so that's $9,200 that was too.
I could not account for them in last year's budget.
So those are the three big differences, other than some inflation adjustments for all your other. Other than salaries, which we're going to do later on, more discussions.
Yeah. Well, the good thing is the revenue from the landing fees will offset some of the costs like the mower.
What was the first check?
That's compact.
That's right, compact money anyway. Yeah. Yep. What was it? What did we estimate this year?
$50,000.
$50,000.
So the revenue portion of this sheet that you gave us, Frank, doesn't include landing fees.
No. And we did include it in the budget, though.
Yeah, but not on
that sheet. Not on that sheet.
Because we had not gotten any information or a check.
Oh, no, I know. Kate Baird just agreed to it not too long ago.
Yeah. Oh, it just started in April.
Right.
When they get the new.
But we
didn't know about it.
We fell through the cracks. We did not bill them. We just billed them. And we just got, got a check to catch us all off.
So only $21,000
increase.
Right? You get $21,000 check this week. So we went
this way. Right.
Which is nice.
We still don't have revenue from the FAA, though.
I know. I sent them an email yesterday.
For the rental?
They refuse to pay because there's a long, drawn-out explanation why. But the short story is they're saying that they don't rent as much space.
The other thing is we have somebody in Potsdam that potentially would like to rent a space in the old hangar for the wintertime, a larger plane. we're going to see if we accommodate them, and they'll pay us a rental fee additional that we don't have on here either. So we're working on that right now.
I'll go back to concept, if you want to go back to concept, gentlemen. This is not for Frank as much as it is for the board. Many years ago, took a trip, I bring it up every year, to talk about how much money this airport costs our taxpayers. And we have competition with other airports who have authorities, etc. They have ability to get the money that we can't get at. I'll say it again, as I've said time in and time out, we need to set up a committee, and we need to get that that airport running on its own, raising its own funds, just like Broome County did. Binghamton, I think, was when we went, Sandy Cook was supervisor, when we all flew down there, it was a county municipal airport. They were losing money, they were bleeding money like crazy on the tax, well, not bleeding money, taxpayers had to pay a lot of money. And the county put together a group, I don't know how they, I forget how they did it, I think it was an authority, it ended up being an authority, and they went ahead and they turned that airport from being a cost to the taxpayers to running and operating on its own. And I still think, again, this concept, I won't be here to go forward with it, but I think you need to do that.
Water towns are going to do something very similar.
Well, that can be done. The only way that can be done is with more than 10,000 plaintiffs. So if that authority can do.
I don't think so.
Where are the other revenue sources going to come from?
You'd have to have an active fixed-based operator who can go publicly if it's out.
You think that business is in Messina?
I don't know. That's
no,
the question.
No, I don't think so.
No. That's the question.
No. But I think 10,000 people are. All the studies have shown they're there, but
it's well, you're using a what demographic are you using?
All the studies that we've hired,
but I don't forget,
these three different studies have shown that there's enough traffic between Southern Ontario.
Well, that's what I'm saying.
To get
when
10,000
you factor people. When you factor Canada into the equation, you might.
Oh,
but as long as you have two airports 35 miles from each other, you're not going to get to 10,000 enplanements.
I think you could.
I pull the weather.
If we had, it's a chicken and egg thing, though. We've known it for a long time. You need a bigger plane. To have a bigger plane, you need a bigger runway.
I don't believe that.
I don't.
You need to have a bigger runway to have a bigger plane.
What? Joe, how long is Watertown's runway?
We can the plane that landed at Watertown, we can land.
We can land a 46 or 48 passenger turbojet on our airport as it is.
We flew out of here.
That's not widening it. That's not lengthening it. And it doesn't have the costs that would come with extending that runway. You can land that plane in Messina.
Well, I think that's different than what any of the EAS people have ever told us.
Well, the problem
they're not
is,
the problem is
an EAS takedown there, right?
Right.
American Eagle bid on that thing. Nobody else bid on ours.
Nobody else bid it.
Right.
So.
Well, and again, they can't. They haven't been convinced that than the 10,000 planes is capable.
Right.
But we've increased our employment significantly under Cape Air.
It'll be interesting to see.
With an 8-passenger airplane.
Yes.
So.
But we don't have the figures.
Bottom line is, no matter who runs it, for it to break even, it needs a lot more business.
Sure.
Unless we get 10,000 employments for it to make money. Whether we run it, whether
Ogden's
fixed base guy runs it, whether it's an authority.
Well, with the fixed base operator, you lose revenue too, because typically he takes the revenue or he takes the revenue as fixed base. Yeah.
The new 2014 Ford Focus sedan is your friend at the pump and your love on the road. The new Focus is driving dynamics at its best. And if you're looking for fuel economy, then this is your car. How about this new 2014 Ford Focus sedan? It features Sync Voice activated services, 6-speed automatic transmission, gets an estimated 37 miles per gallon highway and more. Right now, lease this one for 36 easy payments of just $179 a month. Frenchie's Ford, 216 East Orva Street, Messina, or visit FrenchiesFord.com. Ford, go further.
There's always something going on at St. Lawrence Center. What brings you to St. Lawrence Center? I love all the products and entertainment too. What brings you to St. Lawrence Center? Their prices are affordable. It's my favorite place to go to have lunch. There's always something going on at St. Lawrence Center.
Mike Jones, we're down at StarTech at 260 East Orvis Street, right across from Frenchie Chevrolet. We have computer equipment, cellular telephones, and music equipment, and we'd like to tell you about one of the deals we got going on today.
Smokey here at StarTech Computer with the GMC Bulldozer computer package. This is a Foxconn motherboard with an AMD CPU. It has a quad-core 2.6 GHz socket AM3 processor. It's 3GB of DDR2 RAM. It has a 500GB SATA 3 hard drive, a DVD RW burner with LightScribe, and we're packaging this with Windows 7, a Logitech USB keyboard and mouse, and an iInk 28-inch full 1080p LCD flat panel display. This computer package has 7 cooling fans plus the CPU cooling fan, 3 of which are LED. As you can see, they're red on the case. It has 2 thermal sensors, so you can keep an eye on your temperatures. And it has a vertical CD-ROM tray. And I'll show you that right now. Makes this computer very unique. The package is starting at $14.99. If you come in, we might be able to cut you a deal.
StarTech, computer, cellular, and music equipment.
I don't have the employment figures. We went to the airport.
I just said the Lions meetings.
And Ogdensburg shows a significant rise in Canadian traffic, and they're not near. We're both in the $7,000 range as far as employment.
But we were about four.
Yeah, I know.
6 or 7 years ago.
But what I'm saying is that they're drawing from Ottawa, which is pretty much a straight shot. Plattsburgh has captured the Montreal traffic, which is pretty much a straight shot. What we're trying to convince them to do is to market in Eastern Ontario and Western Quebec.
Right.
I just sent you an email today that I received from,
I was going to say is, in the discussions we had with Cape Air, we cannot, with the flights they have, with the airplane they have, at 100% capacity, cannot reach 10,000 planes. The actual 100% capacity was about 9,500. Okay, so unless we get a bigger than an 8-passenger plane or more flights from Cape Air, we can't get 10,000 under the current setup. We cannot do it. So unless something changes from an EAS, where they can afford to put more into here, it doesn't matter who runs that place. You will never generate the revenue. I'm looking in a crystal ball.
Yeah.
I don't think you're going to be able to generate the revenue to make that a positive.
Al's only main point was that
We don't need to extend the runway to get a bigger plane.
Okay.
To get a 100 passenger plane.
We need more business to get a bigger plane.
Or we need a different company to bid on EAS.
Okay.
Which is what Watertown got this time around.
Yeah, EAS is not going to allow them to add a flight.
Okay, so until we get that, we don't, my point is, I guess, bottom line is we don't need to do anything different than what we're doing now.
But Joe, isn't it true that some of those airplanes have bigger capacity and they can land on our runway, but they won't because...
Well, yeah, there is that part.
There's certain times that they say, we can land there, but
yes, our pilots refuse to do that.
That's what they told us.
Well, not even the pilots, their insurance companies won't let them with the plane load of passengers. But our runway right now is bigger, longer than Watertown. So the 48 passenger plane that landed out of Pleasure could land here.
Right. But it's financially feasible at Watertown. That's the bottom line. The answers they give us because they're businessmen.
Well, they sell the market. That's why they sell the
market.
Now, but here's something else when it comes to market. I forwarded to you today an email that I got from Cape Air. They finally get to put up their first French language ad in Canada.
Yeah, pretty nice.
Yeah, it is pretty nice. And in my limited French, I even understood most of what it said. And it's great. It's going into to one paper in Valley Field. Le Soleil is one of them, which is the Sun, and there's another town. I can't remember what town it is. I think two French language papers. So hopefully we're going to start drawing some people, some French speakers as well as English speakers who live outside of Cornwall and outside of Cornwall. So if we see a rise of Canadian passengers that Ockenberg has seen at some point, that maybe that'll get some interest in the future EAS contract.
May help with the new bridges, will do.
Well, that's true.
The drawback for them.
Yeah. Is anybody, I contacted one of those outfits. Has anybody talked to anybody about trying to bring some charters in and out of here?
We've looked at that, Chuck. Where Saranac Lake makes the lion's share of their money is the 2 weeks of the equestrian show in Lake Placid, where those private planes come in. And Joe and I talked to the casino at one time about bringing high rollers into the airport. At the time, we were looking for help with the runway, but nothing came of it.
There's one thing that we don't do that could potentially help our airport. You saw a clip in the paper a couple days ago. The OBPA was just down in Las Vegas, trying to find business for Augsburg Airport. We don't park our airport. We don't have anybody who does that. We don't hire anybody to do that for us. Now, I think there are two things. So that's the first thing. If we want to think about and it's certainly a good use of casino money. Hire somebody to, in essence, go out and promote our airport and market it to people that will use it. Now, who those people are, where they are, I don't know. I would hope somebody in aviation would be able to tell us. There are companies that do that. CNS does some of that, certainly. There are other companies like Sixel, what's the one in Waterloo? Passaro. They do that kind of marketing, too. But anyway, they're primarily engineering firms. So that's one thing. You know, the other thing that I've been thinking about for a long time, even before Christina Airport, before I got into this job, the Augsburg Bridge and Port Authority isn't an authority just for Augsburg. It is a regional authority from New York State. They were supposed to be looking at promoting and developing the entire region, not just the Augsburg Bridge and Port. And we let them off the hook all the time because the OBPA board sits there and they concentrate on the bridge, and on their port, and on their airport. But that is not, from what I understand, I've never seen their charter. From what I understand, their charge was to be a much more regional authority than they are. So, you know, and is it a possibility they can manage our airport too? Or we can get together and we agree that we're going to manage one airport? I don't know. But I think at some point down the road, when people finally decide to set aside these provincial attitudes and all these turf wars, and especially protecting turf, we'll look at the OBPA as truly a regional authority that can benefit our entire region, not just the city of Augsburg or the port and the airport and the bridge. There's my soapbox that will get me tarred and feathered in Hartford, probably, but anyway.
Well, no, but I mean, this comes up every year, like Chuck said. There's two things about EAS. Number one, is it going to be there? Okay, personally, I think it is. Because the concept of EAS is to, you know, transportation for rural areas, underpopulated areas, and so on. But the second question is, how long will they continue to fund two airports 35 miles from each other? So there's where your turf war will begin.
Frenchy Chevrolet has your new 2014 Chevrolet and the lease deal you've been waiting for. Check out this real deal. Check out this new 2014 Chevy Cruze LTZ that features a power sunroof, Pioneer audio sound system, remote start, and much more. Right now, lease this one for 39 easy payments of just $239 a month. That's less than $8 a day. Frenchy's Chevrolet, 255 East Orvis Street, Messina, or visit FrenchyChevy.com. Chevrolet, find new roads.
If you have a business and need more than just a computer salesman, StarTech is your answer. We have four technicians available with over 60 years combined experience for fast, efficient, quality service. We've been serving upstate New York since 1983. We support local and wide area networks, and we service most makes and models of computers and printers. We have a complete in-house service facility, and we offer on-site service to most areas.
StarTech, computer, cellular, and music equipment.
Supporting a green agenda, Wiley Trash Removal has been serving the community for over 40 years. Wiley Trash Removal also recycles cardboard and paper. Call 315-764-0038.
They made an effort.
All of the North American authorities, yeah.
They're asking us for more information than we
need. They want more input from us.
They want us, right. And I can't ask Frank to take more time away from Highway to go and help market the airport. I only can do so much.
Well, that's my point.
Right,
that's
exactly.
Before you jumped in, that's what I was going to say.
Yeah.
Take some money and get somebody that can help Frank.
Well, the BDC was the lead.
Yeah.
We had a $400,000 grant that was mostly for marketing. That, what the heck was their name, that company?
They're out of Montreal.
Inova.
Okay, and most of that we got very little impact out of, other than that it helped us get Cape Air.
Yeah, who was the
that? Really, Cape Air.
Marty
Burrell.
Yeah, I know. That's true. So we spent lots of money.
All I know is I brought the Weather Channel to find the weather on Monday morning, and the first thing I see is they're advertising the Watertown Airport, right there on their page, right there. I mean, fly out of Watertown.
Mm-hmm. Good airport.
So is Cape Air though? A bunch of websites.
Well, then use more combat money to help pay for the airport, all the expenses.
All the North Country authorities have ignored Messina Airport.
Sure they have.
There's lots of North Country authorities and they all ignore it.
Look at Tug Hill.
Nothing.
Right? They're very regional. And OBPA is this big. And they should be this big, in my
they should be looking from Morristown to the Franklin County Airport.
Anything else you want to talk about with the airport, Frank? Have a nice sturdy pot pretty good here. Okay.
No.
I still sit here and tell you, that was several years ago after going on that trip down there and saw what they did in Broome County. That's, you got to look at it.
One of the things that I've talked to CNS about briefly is, before we put a new industrial park on Horton Road or anywhere else, let's change the damn zoning at our airport, get it where it should be, because they're rural agricultural, it's a special interest, I believe, affecting the zoning before. And let's do some economic development, let's do some industrial development at the airport.
Sure.
We got all this acreage there.
We have an abundance of land.
Look at the area around Syracuse Airport. Even look at the around Watertown, same thing, industrial.
Every major airport has stuff all over it.
And we're
flying to O'Hare Airport, you'll see
Horizon residential
tons of stuff surrounding that.
Maybe that's a step forward, and then maybe you might be able to get some business.
Watertown has a business center in their airport.
Yes.
They get off the plane, go into a conference room, get their transact their business, get back on the plane, and go wherever they're going.
Pilot's lounge, updated pilot's lounge.
Yeah, that'd be a start.
Be a start.
One of the things we should look at, Frank, and we talked briefly about it, we put in a CNS help, they did the work, we threw in some ideas, to try to get a grant to redo the pilot's lounge at the old hangar, which is a mess, as big a mess as the old hangar is. Which I wasn't big on sinking more money in, but if we could get the grant, well, at least it would improve what we have. But I still think we need to look at some sort of mobile unit, some kind of mobile home, mobile facility that we could put out there next to the airport, next to the hangar rather, where it could be a pilot's lounge, it could be a business center, and if we build it in the terminal, we could easily move it to a new hangar rather.
You want me to explore that?
Yeah.
Some more?
All right, yeah.
I'll be there sometime. Yeah. We'll get you some information on it.
Okay.
You have a huge problem in town.
Well, I'll tell you, you can laugh. It's already been brought
that
up.
Yeah.
The BBC's already brought that up. Can we take Troutman's house, convert that into a business center for the airport? Same kind of thing they have in Watertown.
Yeah.
And we haven't discounted that fact.
Right.
But also, I think though.
It's a lop off the top story, I think.
I think it can't be occupied, even though it's resident. It wouldn't be considered residential. You still can't have people in there meeting because it's next to the airport.
I thought
President
Hyde. Yeah,
you have to take the top off.
You
have to take
the top
off. Yeah.
But the property's on the property.
Yes.
So we could knock it down.
Sure.
Something there if we wanted.
Sure. That's another thing we connect to.
It could move the fence and connect to. It could connect to the industrial park as well.
Right. Do we want to heat that this year?
What's that?
50.
Just the house itself.
We have no bids for anything.
Somebody called me two weeks ago and wanted to look at it. I met at 2:30. I got there and nobody showed up.
Yeah.
We still have people interested in demolishing it, but
will that make a difference if it's heated?
I think over time it just deteriorates faster. The interior, that's all.
Deteriorate a lot faster.
What did it cost us last year?
It was only cost of $30 or $40 a month.
I think it left at 50 degrees.
Yeah. I mean, the water's off. I mean, there's nothing.
Yeah, there's no water to burst, but.
Why let the sheetrock go?
The moisture's going to build up now.
All right,
keep it 50 years.
I'm going to say Morris Castle call because they put a new meter in there. We'll just have to leave it off in the summertime. Okay. If you want it back on.
Okay. Good. Anything else tonight, Grandma?
I'm tired
from
what we did.
I think this is a good session. I think so too. We don't have enough of these farm ranges.
I'm pretty happy with the budget. So.
I got questions going. I get asked, write them down. I don't want to keep you here any later.
Sammy,
you should have seen the old days. I'd have four pages of questions. Yeah, I don't know. He's looking at my notes. Holy Christmas.
Trying to keep up with it.
Nah.
one good thing about the upcoming plowing season, price of a ton of salt went from $52 to $42 a ton. So it dropped $10 a ton this year.
That's nice.
Yeah.
Cool, let's have some margaritas.
Different kind.
We can make ice cream out of it.
Are we going to take any questions?
Yes, ma'am.
I loved your article in the paper about nonprofit. I loved it with quotes. You did a good job.
Thanks.
Now, if they only listen, you'll be all set.
Who's they? The nonprofit?
What's nonprofit?
She's a nonprofit.
Yeah, but who do you want to listen? The nonprofits or?
The nonprofit and the board.
Oh, my. I didn't expect to see them this year.
Well, I restored a little bit, but.
It was true what you said.
Well, thanks. I think it is. I think it's unavoidable.
The two equipment purchases, Frank, $20,000 for a new mower. What's the other one?
New backhoe.
You know about price on
it? Highway garage. The mower is for the airport.
Yeah.
And the new pickup for the highway garage.
Oh, okay.
Backhoe and pickup.
Do you have prices for those?